Lair of the Clockwork God is a half-platformer, half-point-and-click adventure from independent game studio Size 5 Games. You control two friends named Ben and Dan, each featuring their own distinct playstyles and capabilities. Ben and Dan represent the game's real-life designers, so the characters' crude and snarky dialogue feels authentic and relatable. Characters and levels poke fun at game genres and the game industry at large with self-aware humor. Even when the game takes some dark turns, Ben and Dan's witty banter helps to lighten the mood. Ben is the adventurer of the duo. In true point-and-click style, he's capable of solving puzzles by examining and using items he collects along the way. Ben can also craft upgrades for Dan that will help him with his platforming, such as double jump boots. The only caveat is that Ben can't run or jump himself, meaning he moves remarkably slow. He must rely on Dan's piggybacking to travel significant distances throughout each level. Conversely, Dan is the indie platformer sidekick who jumps and sprints his way through each environment. With the help of Ben's upgrades and strategically placed jump pads and portals in the world, Dan can quickly move around, stopping to push and move objects as necessary. The game primarily consists of swapping between both Dan and Ben to maneuver through each level. For the most part, the pair travels together, but there are some levels where Ben and Dan become separated and must work through the level individually before reuniting near the end. Dan's platforming capabilities are mostly tight and succinct. The 2D platforming levels themselves aren't overly difficult or punishing, though there are a few moments in each section that test your dexterity. There is also plenty of checkpoints along the way, so ultimately deaths never put you too far behind. I found the point-and-click puzzle-solving sections much more challenging, as they typically require you to thoroughly explore the environment for clues and understand how various objects interact with one another. Nearly everything Ben interacts with is important in some way, and solving puzzles often comes down to paying attention to small details in your inventory or your surroundings. The point-and-click puzzles are the more rewarding of the two gameplay mechanics in Lair of the Clockwork God. There are a few known bugs to watch out for, such as Dan briefly getting stuck in the ground after landing on Ben's head. In one of the early chapters, I also ran into an issue where I couldn't swap to Ben, and as a result, I had to restart the chapter over again, which you can do from the main menu. And while restarting is not an ideal way to solve puzzles, bugs or otherwise, it's nice to have this option when you truly are stumped and want to restart a puzzle chapter over again. There is also an in-game store that supposedly allows you to buy hints to help you solve a puzzle, but the store was inaccessible during the time of this review. Though there's a few head-scratchers that may slow down your progress, solving the point-and-click puzzles in Lair of the Clockwork God still felt satisfying overall. The platforming punctuates the slow pacing of the point-and-click sections, helping to make the game feel a bit more eventful. Although there are a few kinks that need ironing, the game does a decent job of overlapping two different game genres into a fun, cohesive experience. Lair of the Clockwork God is available now on Steam for $19.99, but it is 10% off until February 28th.